What's up, guys? 6's Grizzly back here again with another video. This video is on how to lace Jordan 6's. As you see, I got my drones. This video was requested from another YouTuber. He's good. He has good videos. He's a sneaker YouTuber. Go check out his videos. I'll put a link in the description. Shout out to you, Exclusive Retros. He has good videos. He posts up good content. And he just needs to post up more content. He said he wanted me to check out his YouTube channel, and I did. I liked the videos. I liked a couple of them. And I'll subscribe to you too. But he wanted to have a video on how to lace the 6's, the Jordan 6's. And I'm gonna use my rooms as a demonstration. So just give me a second, we're gonna get into the video. Now first, there's a lot of ways you can lace up your own 6's. You can lace them the way that you want to, and then you can lace them the way that factory laces, you know. But I mean, like I said, I always try to put style into it, you know what I'm saying? Different than everybody, but right now I'm just show you, so give me a moment. So first I'm gonna show you, obviously, I got the Jordan 6 maroon right here. I think this was a pretty good cop. I will be talking about I will be doing a review on this. It's just I've been so late on these. I got a lot of sneakers that I copped. I mean, not a lot, but I've got some sneakers that I've copped recently, and I haven't done a review on them yet. Sorry if you hear the fan right here. It's because, like, right now there's no daylight at all, so I can't record. I don't want y'all to be like, we ain't got no lighting forever. So, yeah, that's why you hear that sound. But no, so there's two ways you can do it, because with the Jordan 6, they got this little button type thing right here, and that's just a little area where it's like that. But I'm going to unlace my shoes, and I'm going to give you a depth of review of how to lace them, so just give me a second. I'm going to show you I'm gonna first show you the non-lace lock move, and I'm gonna go into it. So this is non-lace lock, okay? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna first, if it's not already pre-laced, you're gonna first take this button right here, pull it down, right? Now you're gonna see this in the middle, right? So then you're gonna take this shoelace, right? Gonna go through right here, right through this hole. Okay. So once you feed it through the middle, right? Once you feed it through the middle, after that, you're gonna put that right there, and you're gonna take this one and you're gonna feed it through this hole in the middle. That shoe, boom, I'm feeding it through. So now you got the laces like this. I know it took me a long time. So now you got the laces like this, right? So then you're gonna take this lace, the right lace, you're gonna take the right side lace and feed it through this one, right? You're gonna feed it through this hole, just the same.
this one too. What are you saying?
Now, me, I usually just pull it out, you know what I'm saying? So, get a little space, boom. Right? And then, get into this one. This one, I recommend putting it through the bottom thing. So, put it through right there. Right? Put it through the hole. And then just put this one on top. And then for to keep them from not moving out of the place, like displacement right here, just put that button on until you hear that snapping. That's the non-lace lock move. So you can do this with your Jordan 6's if you want to. Now I'm about to show you the lace lock move. Now, this is the easiest one, honestly. Here is how to do the lace lock method. It's pretty easy. It should be easy for you to understand how to go through it. So first, I straighten out my laces a little bit before I start to work on them and lace them up. So just okay. Then you don't have to do this, but I do it. I like to keep my laces even. Even. Just give me a second. I know I sound like a hype beast for doing this, but that's just how I am. Like, when it comes to my shoes, I'm a meat freak with my shoes. Like I said in my Jordan 4 video. Okay, it's semi even, I guess you could say. Alright. Okay, so now let's get started, right? So, I'm gonna take this lace, right? Put it behind this strap. Boom. I'm gonna take the other lace on the other side, put it behind that strap, right? Not gonna close the strap yet. You wanna tuck these laces in a little bit, right? So then you're gonna wanna, take the lace that's on this side, put it through this top hole, and then pull. Right. Pull. And then you're gonna take this lace, right? And you're gonna put it through this top hole. Then, after you do all that, hold on, I gotta fix this. After you're done doing all that, you tuck this in real quick. After you're done doing that, you're gonna take this, the other side again, one more time, and then you're just gonna feed it through the top hole, which is the last hole. Just put it in, right? After that's done, then. That through, and then now this is the last steps, right? So pull that, got that through. Now take this one, put it through the other top hole. So your shoes should now take this in. So then your shoes should. It should look close to it or near it, or it should look like it. So your shoes should look like that, right? So then you're gonna click this top. So you're gonna wanna hear that snap. Once you can hear that snap, then you're gonna wanna take your lace lock right here. Nike Jordan. So you're gonna take the lace lock, grab these two, right? And then you're gonna wanna hold them to. So then you're gonna take this and feed it through. I'm just gonna. And you're just gonna wanna feed them to both through. And this method, these methods, I should say, these methods work with the shoe pretty well, in my opinion. I think, matter of fact, just do one. I mean, that's how I did the first time, but for some reason, like, I don't know why it's not going through. Do one right there, and then take the other lace lock. I mean, take the other shoe lace, and then put the lace lock. Then you're gonna want to just. I like to make sure that it looks good when it's even or not even. And then you just. 3, 2, 1. Pull. And got your shoes like that. You know, if you want a little bit of space, pull it a little bit up front. You know what I'm saying? And it actually looks dope. So, enjoy the way how you laced up your Jordan 6's. This was Skizzy Grizzly 514 coming back at you with another video. This is another how-to on how to lace your Jordan 6's. Thank you for requesting this video. Exclusive retros. Back with the video again. Hope you really like this video. I took my time out of doing this. It's late night right now. But yeah, guys, I hope you liked the video. But this was how to lace your Jordan 6's. Requested by Exclusive Retros. Go check his YouTube channel out. There will be a link in the description. I really hope you liked this video. Because, you know, I'm always giving out how-tos and stuff. I'm trying to work on scooter stuff for my scooter people. I still scooter, yes. I'm just trying to figure out. Like, I've been trying to, like, work on new ways on to how to get to the skate park and stuff, because I haven't been able to go to the skate park. My scooter shoes, like, right now, they don't fit me because I went up a size and went to a size 14. And it's hard to find shoes in my size because I'm a tall dude with big feet, and they're wide and they're fat, so it's hard to find a good skate shoe, and I don't like skating Vans, and you're gonna be like, what, you don't like Vans? I mean, people made them just, you know what, this will be another video, so I hope you liked the video, hope you liked the way how you lace your Maroon 6's, this was another video from Stizzy Grizzly, I am signing out, peace, oh yeah. One more thing, make sure to go follow me on Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter. Snapchat and Instagram, that will let you know when I come out with a new video. Twitter automatically lets you know, because once I upload the video, I will be uploading the video at, I'm not sure what time it is right now, but I will be uploading the video. You guys should know this already, it's Dizzy Grizzly. I am on spring break, so I will be posting up some good content because I've been stressed out lately because of school. I know it sounds crazy, but it's the truth. And guys, I hope you like my videos. Just continue to watch them, and I will continue to post. Hopefully, I hit up to that Kaiso Morel. Shout out to you, Kites. Cool TV, Dream Critical, you know what I'm saying? Maybe one day, if Delaware ever gets another sneaker convention, you should come down, bro. Because actually, my cousin, for the first sneaker convention in the sneaker show in Delaware, my cousin, I didn't know until like my mom told me, but my cousin is a sneakerhead also like me. But he's been in the game way longer than me. And he was the person who made it. So, I didn't get to go, sadly. My friends did. All the people that go to school. But yeah. So, that's it. And, oh yeah, one more thing. I will be showing you guys or giving you ideas. Because I am going to start up my own restorations, customs, and just it's gonna be a little business of my own. Maybe my friend might join again because we already had a name set planned out. It's called DNA Kicks. Mine's is Dorian. It stands for Dorian and like DNA. Dorian Andy Kicks. Basically, that's what it's supposed to be. Dorian and Andy Kicks. But DNA Kicks. I came up with the name Andy. I put his link in the description too. This is He Don't Fleek channel, He Don't Fleek 23 or He Don't Fleek something like that. I can't remember. But he needs to post up more videos. That's why I'm trying selling my camera. Because I'm not talking about this camera. This is my phone. I'm never selling my phone. I love iPhone 6. But I know I keep on getting my track. But guys, he will be posting up videos. I will both put exclusive retros and He Don't Fleek channels in the description. Please go check them out. They got good videos just like I do. I will see you later. Peace, guys. Keep it with that while I'm out. Yeah. Oh, and guys, I've been getting on my rap shit lately. I know it sounds crazy. Your boy can rap. He can freestyle still. He can sing. I can't do that, my rap. Nah, I can't do that. But yeah, guys, I had did a couple of freestyles last night. It was crazy. It sounded so dope. I know I messed up on a couple of stuff, but it sounded crazy. It was so fucking. It was so fucking lit. Like, I am literally lit by myself. But I had did an Uber Everywhere freestyle. Killed that. I did I don't know if y'all know Famous Dex from Chicago. Like, I like his music. I fuck with him heavy. I mean, not fuck with him heavy, but I fuck with him, you know what I'm saying? But he be like, I be getting it good. I get the gym, I'm like, oh, I get the gym, oh, boy. I get the gym, I'm like, oh, man, goddamn. Oh, man, goddamn. I get the drift from my wall. I get the drift from my wall. I get the drift from my wall. I get the drift. Oh, man, goddamn. Oh, man, I'm dripping, dribble. But now I did the song I get the drip from my walk. That was a song from him, but I remixed it myself. I did a freestyle to it. I did a wicked freestyle, you know. I know y'all guys are like, what the fuck is wrong with this name? Oh yeah, and I did a cut it remix. Soon I'm finna get on my rap shit. But yeah, guys, like it, comment, subscribe, peace, see you guys. I'm about to check the boost.